Welcome back to another ORM Mastery tutorial. Don't forget you can access all the tutorials in this course. There is a link in the video description. And of course, if you love this course, then you can go ahead and use our link in the video description to get the best price for our Udemy course. Having now created our new link or intermediate table, let's take a look at how we can interface this new table within the Django admin site. This tutorial is a baseline introductory tutorial, creating a tabular inline, which allows us to edit models on the same page as a parent model. If you want to follow along step by step, you can do. The code is available for download in this tutorial's resources. This is where we left off in the previous tutorial. We've created now our new product category link or intermediate table here, and we've defined the through option from new product to build our connection from product to the category table. It can be sometimes convenient for us to register our tables in the admin site so that we can add and edit data in our tables. If you are following along at this point, you'll need to create a virtual environment. Go ahead and run the pip install requirements. You'll need to then make migrations and then finally migrate. So for this example, we navigate into inventory admin. Let's go ahead and import our models that we want to work with, category product and product category. I just go ahead and register the new product category intermediate table. I will need to create a superuser to access the admin panel. So I'm going to run the create superuser. I'm just going to create a new user admin. Leave this blank and then admin password. There we go. So now that we have that in place, let's go ahead and run the server. So our Django server is now running. Let's go over to the admin here and we'll log in as admin. And you can see here that we've got the product category table already and set up. Next up, let's register our category and product table. So here first we have the category table. Just add a pass to that. And then in addition to that, we also then need our product. So we go ahead and register our product table and pass on that. Now, I do want to pre-populate a field. So in the category here, I want to pre-populate the slug field with the name that we enter. And that will be the same for the product table. So we'll bring that in also for the product table. Now, all this code is in the resource. So we've added now that into our code. Now that should be live straight away. So back in our admin here, let's just refresh and we can now access both the categories and product tables. So let's go into categories here and let's just add a new category. Let's call this cat1. You can see that the slug is automatically populated and we'll activate that, press save. Right, so if we go over to products here, what we want potentially is that when we add a product, we want to automatically add that to categories. Now, by default, of course, this form will only show based upon the information that's inside the products table here or the model of the product table. So we want to build an inline, which is going to provide us an additional option to allow us to select the category and then populate our new product category table. Taking a look visually what we're trying to achieve here, we have already added data into the category table here on the right hand side. So what we're trying to do now is add a product data and at the same time add information into the product category intermediate table. Although it is possible for us to enter information into the product category table once we've created a product, it seems like a good idea as we create a product to then build that relationship to the category table. So building the inline in the admin area for a product, we can select the category and automatically insert data into the product category table. So back in our admin file here, we're going to create a category inline. So just below here, let's go ahead and build a category inline. We're using the tabular inline. There are a few different options if you look at the Django documentation. And we're going to then just define the model. So the important part here is that when we build an inline with the through option that we've defined manually, you can see that we're going to define the dot through at the end. So essentially the model is product. So we're defining or specifying the model product here, and then we're specifying the many-to-many field, and then the fact we're going to then utilize the through option, and that would then define our new intermediate table that we've developed. So we need to remember the through here. Right, so once that is in place, we then need to specify our inline in the appropriate table. In this case, it's going to be the product inline here. So I add my inline, define it, the fact it's the category inline that we've created up here. And now when we go back into the admin, we should now see, on refreshing the page, the new inline at the bottom here, this new form. And that gives us the option of then selecting a category. So in this case, we've selected category one. I press save. And then let's go back into now our product category table. And you can see that has been automatically populated. If we inspect the data, you can see that we have product one connected to category one. So if you are looking to utilize the admin site to populate data in the database, using inlines and connecting it to our new intermediate table can be done in that way. So I realized for some that was quite a long-winded tutorial just to tell you about dot through. Other than that, the approach to creating a tabular inline is exactly the same. Of course, there are many different options now that we could apply. That's a little bit out of scope of this course, but hopefully I've given you enough information so that you can start to utilize your new intermediate table in the Django admin site.